he had a great respect for the orchestra, and he would address everyone as my dear, and I think he actually meant it.
He was so endearing and very caring, and when he spoke to you, he would catch your eye, and you really felt like he was talking to you.
He knew that you were attempting something right at the edge of possibility, that the players were doing their utmost, and they were doing it with him and for him, and he had faith in his players, and that makes a difference.
When Solti joined, the Chicago Symphony was still a provincial orchestra. It hadn't toured outside of the United States, and I think Solti added this impetus to the orchestra to be the superstars in the symphonic world and to be on the cover of Time magazine and to almost blow the roof off of Carnegie Hall. And it was partly his ambition and partly the fact that the orchestra was able to do that.
The CSO is anxious to show you what we can do. We're anxious to knock your socks off. We're anxious to be the very best. Solti saw that, he understood it, he said, that's me, and that worked great.
Solti came, and it was immediately a feeling of grandeur and stature and high quality music making all of the time.
There was a clarity and a crispness that was so identifiable. Solti had that ability to get across what he wanted, and instead of going boom, he could get bam.
The thing that I remember about Solti was the fact that he respected every member of the orchestra, and then he was very keen on having this high standard maintained.
We must maintain our standard, my dears. This is the most difficult thing.
Because he'd come back at the beginning of every season, having conducted elsewhere, and he would always report to us.
I conducted New York, my dears, and they are good, but we are better.
And then he would come back from Boston one year.
I conducted Boston, my dear. They are very good, but we are still better, and we must maintain our standard.
And then he came back one year, and he told us,
I conducted in Berlin, my dear. They are as good as we are. We must be better, and we must raise our standard, my dears. And this is the most difficult thing.
That was almost a mantra with him, to maintain the standard and to raise the standard and to be as good as we are and better.
His style of rehearsal involved going through a piece in its entirety, beginning to end, from which we gained a sense of pacing, both physical and emotional. And he studied the music so hard, you could almost say it was calculated. You might think that such a well-prepared style might be a recipe for dull performance, but he had an internal fire that was just unquenchable, irrepressible.
He never apologized for his voice. He would sing in a falsetto. And the indication would be not only the sustaining of something, but the release of the sound or the stop of the sound.
But he also had this unique way of putting syllables to the notes, like, but they weren't, it wasn't solfege, it was like bada buda bida. You'd think, I don't know how I'm getting what he wants me to do, but you did. You somehow got it.
And what Solti was looking for wasn't perfection in the sense of no perfect performances. He was looking for the other things. He was looking for the drama and for the musical statements that he wants to make.
And I think this is, in a certain way, what we have now with Maestro Muti coming in. The orchestra, under the leadership of a strong maestro like Maestro Muti, has literally no limits.
And the standard is just as high as Solti or Barenboim, if not higher.
I think what Solti gave the orchestra was this incredible foundation and work ethic of wanting to be the best, wanting to do the best. If I could talk to him one last time, for sure the thing I would say was, thank you for giving me the chance of playing with this great orchestra.
I just have to thank him.
I would just want to say thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Because it's been a great ride. It's been a really wonderful experience, and I will always owe him a lot for that.
Thank you. It was a great, great ride. A great time.